sounds, Chad Johnson, career win number 40, and the Buffalo Sabres come to the desert and pick up yet another road win, and now some pushing and shoving after the final horn. And while they sort this out, Rob, Buffalo has won 5 of their last 7 road games.
Well, it just seems like when they're on the road, more focused, maybe a little more relaxed, and they're able to play the game, but what they've been doing on the road...
Well, they're still going on. They're not separating. It's Bogosian.
He's got his gloves down, and he's throwing punches.
Boy, it is going behind the net. That's Hanzel that he's throwing him with, and here comes the rest of the cavalry. Vermette being kept out by a linesman up near the blue line. Shane Doan is in there. And now away, Ristolainen's throwing him, and here comes some help for Rasmus. Ristolainen to the corner. Overcomes Bogosian as Ristolainen covers up. Foligno is in there.
Now Arizona's going crazy because they're outnumbered in the corner. The linesman's got Antoine Vermette over at the bench, not allowing him in to help. And the Sabres 5-on-4 down low.
Now that linesman comes down to try and help out. It's Ekman Larson, who Rasmus was going at it with.
Look at Raz, he wants another piece of him. This is good to see. I'll tell you what. This third period for the Buffalo Sabres, not the greatest one in the world, but they found a way to come out on top and pull together. In situations like this, you talk about it all the time, especially on the road. They got something important to play for. Pride, they got their family in the building. A lot of things push this hockey team here tonight.
All right, we can take a look, Rob, at how this all starts after the final horn, and Buffalo with the 2-1 win in behind the Sabres' net. The buzzer sounds, and here we go.
That's Vermette and Ristolainen. And Zach Bogosian, the most experienced fighter, you could say, on the ice at that point, comes in and tries to help out. And you see Marcus Foligno there as well.
And in a moment, this is going to turn even a little nastier because here we go.
Well, Antoine Vermette just getting a little damn. Zach Bogosian comes through and gives Duclair just a right, left shot right in the nose. But that's okay.
Oh, boy.
I like this. This is something where you got on the road. You're able to stay together. They're going to talk about this the rest of the night. They're going to talk about it in the dressing room. They're going to talk about it tomorrow at practice and the flight to Colorado. And you can feed off it.
Well, there are a lot of storylines to this game, and I'm sure these two gentlemen coming up next will talk about them all with Alexis Postgame Report, Brian Duff, and Brad May. Gentlemen?
I just want to watch that over and over as we watch them come down the hall. Not a single guy did not enjoy what just transpired, not only in the previous 2.5 hours, but in the final 2.5 minutes. And that, without a doubt, like Rob and Dan just said, galvanizes this group in a situation, in a way, that they haven't gone through together before.
Honestly, I don't understand this at all. People calling for violence in hockey, fighting in hockey. I thought nobody liked it, Brian. I thought, seriously, that was, you know, guys losing their composure, it's not the time to fight.
Well, you can take your tongue out of your cheek at any moment. Exactly.